Today I want to talk about my thoughts on the Destiny 2 Forsaken DLC, and we're going to start right now. What's up guys, Reckless here, welcome to Guardian Watcher. So, I wanted to go over all of my thoughts on the Destiny 2 Forsaken DLC, but before we get into the video, if you guys would like a chance to win the Destiny 2 Annual Pass for any platform of your choice, then you can enter the contest by clicking on the Gleam link in the description. Now, Destiny 2 Forsaken has been out for a little bit over 2 weeks now, so anything I say will pretty much no longer be a spoiler, and I have to say that I am very impressed with this DLC release. It has literally blown away all of my expectations. To date, it probably is the best Destiny 2 release so far. And I will be getting into how I feel most about the DLC, but I will not be covering the raid because as of this video, I have not even attempted to do the raid yet due to wanting my power level a little bit higher. Most of everything I will say is definitely positive and there is a little bit of negative, but I will be vague with the negative things because they will be saved for other videos. So, let's start with the story. Back before Destiny 2 Forsaken was released, we as a community were told that Forsaken gave you that old Western vibe, and I could see the subtle similarities after playing Forsaken, but it wasn't as exaggerated as many made it out to be. In my opinion, I feel that the story for Forsaken had the perfect balance of storytelling, cinematics, missions, adventures, and a strike. The synergy of it all was pretty much unprecedented. Bungie, you did good. Like, very good. Yes, K6 dies, and yes, Marasov, aka the Queen, is in fact still alive. Granted, all of the new adventures revolves around hunting down a different Baron. You can only go so far into Tangleshore before you run into an area that you have already been in. I don't know, I feel that Bungie could have made the Tangleshore a little bit bigger, but also give it a different name given that it's too similar to the name The Tangle on Nessus. That is just a minute detail. Leveling up from 400 to 600 is definitely quite the challenge. Many people went straight into the story mode when Forsaken was launched, and that is not really the proper way to level up. Power leveling to 500, which is also the soft cap, was definitely the best way to level up instead of doing the story first. That way, when powerful engrams drop, they would drop higher than your current power level. Speaking of challenges, the new challenge system versus the old milestone system is definitely an improvement. The introduction to daily challenges gives you something to do on a day-to-day basis instead of waiting an entire week. The same goes for the daily bounties that a lot of the vendors have, including Hawthorne. The slow release of more content in Forsaken is also a good idea. Kind of. So, hear me out. When the Last Wish raid was finally beaten and the world's first was announced, things had changed in the Dreaming City and new things inside the city were available that weren't before. Petra's weekly challenges, I will say, is definitely also fun to do. The new mod system is pretty interesting as well. It just sucks that Banshee 44 only sells two different mods at a time. But even if he sold three different mods, that I think would be better. Gambit. Huh. Well, Gambit is definitely in a league of its own. I thought that I had fun playing Gambit prior to the release of Forsaken, and I was so wrong. Now, Gambit has gotten real. However, the abundance of sleeper simulants in Gambit have ruined the fun for a lot of people. I will admit, I myself am a sleeper user in Gambit because it is extremely powerful. I mean, it one-shots body shots Guardians and it does a crazy amount of damage against the Primeval. But it's supposed to because it's the sleeper. It definitely puts shit to sleep. But on a real note, something does need to happen to sleeper. Now Houndish gave a great idea to fix this issue, and it revolves around the sleeper only one-shotting Guardians if it is a crit shot, which means that you have to get a headshot in order to do a one-shot kill against Guardians in Gambit. I definitely agree with this. It would be a small nerf, but a pretty reasonable. One-shot headshots with the sleeper rewards those who can actually get those crit shots. But if Bungie went the other way and then completely nerfed sleeper simulant, then I would think that the Whisper of the Worm would pretty much take its place. The Whisper has an insane amount of aim assist, and I have seen it a lot in Gambit as well. Other than that, I really love Gambit. From all of the maps to the portals that we could jump into, and it just the concept of Gambit itself was a great idea. And I was thinking about doing a video on Gambit tactics and strategies, and let me know in the comments section if you guys would like to see a video on that. It would also be nice to see a change in enemies when it comes to the blockers and primevals. As of right now, it's only Taken, but if Bungie changed it to kind of like Escalation Protocol, where it has different bosses each week with some type of mechanic that we need to fulfill in order to kill the primeval, that would make Gambit so much better. Now, let's move away from Gambit and talk a little bit about the Tangle Shore, specifically the Spider. As I said earlier, this is where all of the adventures happen, where we have to hunt down the Barons. However, the Spider has bounties from which, after completed, have a chance to drop one of two exotics. Those are the Queenbreaker's Bow and the Lord of Wolves. It's been said, and more so speculated, that you can get these exotics from any of Spider's bounties, and that pretty much includes his daily bounties as well. Now, I thought that you could only get these exotics by doing the Spider's Wanted bounties, but some people are saying that you can get these exotics from any of Spider's bounties, which, like I said, does include his daily bounties. If you have either of these exotics and can confirm which bounties you actually got them from, that would be greatly appreciated. As of the first Iron Banner in Forsaken, light actually matters. And you definitely can see the difference in gun battles when you are 544 versus another Guardian that is like 520. Bringing random rolls back with the release of Forsaken was definitely a good idea. It actually gave me my God roll Better Devils. Unfortunately, with this change came an abundance of rolls with weapons having Outlaw, Kill Clip, Rampage, Moving Target, Zen Moment, and Slide Shot. Yes, these are all great perks, but we don't want to see them on almost every single weapon there is to use. So I really feel like Bungie has to fix that. As for the new Lost Sectors, well, there's really nothing bad to say about them. There was something to either do or activate in order to progress. They weren't like the old Lost Sectors where all you did was just go into the Lost Sector, run past everything, and then kill the boss. The new exotic weapons are pretty cool, but I do feel that the new exotic armor is very gimmicky due to me not really wanting to use certain exotics. For example, as much as I want the Lord of Wolves, I would pretty much never use it. It's pretty much a collector's item until Bungie gives it a buff that would give it a reason to take up my exotic slot as a weapon. And the same goes for exotic armor. The new exotic armor in Forsaken is terrible. There is really no good reason to use them because all of the old exotics prior to Forsaken is so much better. I mean, after the nerf to the Wormhouse Crown, a lot of Guardians went straight to the Stompies, including me, because none of the Forsaken exotics had that oomph. That's like, damn, I gotta have it. However, not all of the new Forsaken exotics are like this. The new Warlock exotic called Phoenix Protocol is probably one of the best new exotics in Forsaken because your super gets extended as long as you get kills and assists. Speaking of exotics, and yes, I know I am doing this a lot, the drop rate for the new Forsaken exotics suck. I mean, I went through my first week and a half of Forsaken, and I didn't even get a single Forsaken exotic weapon or armor. The Ace of Spades doesn't count, because it's a quest that's given to you at the end of the story. My very first Forsaken exotic was given to me literally a week and a half after Forsaken was actually released, but prior to this, I got at least 5 exotics that are pre-Forsaken. My first Forsaken exotic was the Oathkeeper, and after that was Ace of Spades, and then the Chaperone from another quest. Let me know in the comment section what was your very first Forsaken exotic. Some of the Destiny 1 legendary weapons that came with Forsaken are also a great addition. But if we had a chance to get Fatebringer back, then this release would be amazing. I would also like to see other exotics like the Vex Mythoclast, Outbreak Prime, and the Twilight Garrison to make a return as well. Hopefully, if not the weapons, then at least the Twilight Garrison comes back into Destiny 2. But then, we still have so many unanswered questions in Destiny 2. For example, we know that Mara Sov, aka the Queen, is still alive. But we don't even know where she is. And, you know, things like that. Overall, even though that I did mention a lot of negative things, I feel that the Forsaken release has brought new life to Destiny 2 and I hope that things like this does continue through the release of the three upcoming expansions in winter of 2018, spring of 2019, and the summer of 2019. Besides any of these issues that I have said, I really have nothing else bad to say about Forsaken. It is truly a great game. And if you left the game or are undecided if you want to come back, then I can proudly say that it will definitely be worth your time. And that, my friends, brings us to the end of the video. If you enjoyed this video, feel free to watch these videos as well. You never know, you just might like them. And if you do, leave a like, share them, and then come back for more, because you know you want to. Thank you guys for watching, and remember, less guns doesn't mean less crime. And I will see you guys next time.
You fight till there's nothing left. I could use someone like you on my next...